The Golden State Warriors had an extremely underwhelming 2020 NBA season, finishing with the worst record in the entire league, which is crazy to think about considering they had made the NBA Finals just a year prior. This lackluster season was mainly due to injuries, as stars in Klay Thompson and Stephen Curry virtually missed the entire season. Many believe, with a now fully healthy roster, the Warriors will once again be in the title contention conversation in 2021. But I beg to differ. There is a truth that needs to be told about this team, and it's why I personally don't see them becoming an elite team again in 2021 amongst the likes of the Lakers and Clippers. I'm going to be talking about why that is in today's video. Before we start, if you're new here and enjoy the video, be sure to subscribe for more NBA content like this. I'm trying to hit 15,000 subscribers by the end of the year, so all support would be greatly appreciated. Anyway, with that all being said, let's talk about the Golden State Warriors. Lucas. As I mentioned, the Warriors struggled a lot this season due to injuries. Draymond Green was in and out of the team, Klay Thompson missed the entire season with an ACL tear, and Stephen Curry only got around to playing 5 games, mainly due to a fracture in his hand sustained in the opening couple weeks of the season. This meant the Warriors had to rely on very average players to get a lot of their buckets, and the majority of their roster, if on another team, were likely to be sent to the G League, if we're being honest. The only real star for the Warriors, I could say this season, was D'Angelo Russell, who had some amazing games for them and averaged 24 points for the year. But even he didn't finish the season as a Warrior, eventually being traded at the deadline for a future pick and Andrew Wiggins. Another bright spot for the Warriors in such a poor season was the rise of Eric Pascal, who, though inconsistent, was good enough to make all-rookie first team with averages of 14-5 for the year on really solid efficiency. With that said though, it is clear that the Warriors roster this season was very lackluster, and it's pretty obvious why it did not contribute to wins. I mean, if Kai Bowman is starting for you occasionally, it really says something, doesn't it? This is where the problem begins for the Warriors, in my opinion. Let me just read out to you the Warriors' currently listed roster on basketballreference.com. There's Steph Curry, Klay Thompson, Draymond Green, and Andrew Wiggins, which seems all good, but then it takes a turn for the worse. Eric Pascal, Marquise Chris, Jordan Poole, Damian Lee, Kai Bowman, Kevin Looney, Alan Smilagic, Juwan Toscano-Anderson, and Michael Mulder. Yeah, aside from Klay, Curry, Green, and Wiggins as well, I guess, the Warriors roster is clearly extremely weak, filled with very mediocre players and G League guys, who really only played a lot last season due to the core group of players being constantly injured. They no longer have those elite bench players like an Iguodala, Livingston, etc., and are of course missing Durant too now, arguably their best player over the past few seasons. Sure, Pascal and Marquise Chris were solid last season, but they're no Iggy, they're no Harrison Barnes. This could cause some major concerns for the Warriors next season if things don't change, because their current roster looks nowhere near championship contention level. After Wiggins, the talent just drops off a cliff, and this is again very concerning. Curry is not a floor raiser, he's a ceiling raiser, which of course is a good thing as it makes his team's championship level. I'll say a Russell Westbrook's do not. But the problem with that for this upcoming season is the current Warriors roster and how it's built is not going to win a championship next season, even with a healthy Curry. I don't think Curry can carry this team to become a legit finals threat, unfortunately. A guy like Westbrook can take a rubbish team to the playoffs, whilst Curry can take a good team to a championship, if that makes sense. Basically, Curry can make a good team great, but I don't think he can make a bad team great too. The Warriors can save this team though. Obviously, there is the draft, free agency, and trade period ahead, through which the Warriors can upgrade and retool their roster. So I'm not going to say it is doomsday yet. What I will say is if there aren't many changes to this current roster as it stands right now, this Warriors team will not be competing for a championship whatsoever next season and may only become a borderline playoff team. The reason why the Curry-led Warriors from 2014 to 2016 were so good was because they were also so incredibly deep, which created problems for the opposition as the Warriors' offense was so hard to guard due to their unpredictability and versatility. Though Curry will continue to have his historically great gravitational pull, I doubt it will be as effective with a guy like Jordan Poole or Damian Lee on the perimeter, rather than a guy like Iguodala. Again, the Warriors still have the offseason to improve upon this, but right now, things do not look good, and the organization has a lot of questions that need to be answered. Basically, for the Warriors, the hard truth about them is their current roster is simply not great. It's good, and is more likely than not going to get them into the playoffs, especially if Curry can find a form similar to the 2015 to 2016 era. But I don't think it's on a championship level, which is of course this team's ultimate goal. The Warriors do have a chance to improve in the offseason, where they will likely try trade for another star with their number 2 overall pick, but it's definitely going to be a difficult task. The 2021 season for the Warriors is going to be very interesting, as they'll have a lot to prove going in. Can Stephen Curry step up and take this team back to the promised land? Will Klay Thompson return to a similar level after injury? Can Draymond Green become effective again? What will Andrew Wiggins be for them? So many questions that need to be answered, and as I've said many times now, if the supporting cast doesn't improve, I'm not sure how good their answer will be to some of those questions. There's also a lot on the line for Steve Kerr as well, as he faces his toughest challenge yet. How well the Warriors play this season will really determine just how good of a coach he actually is. At the end of the day, the Golden State Warriors will likely be a playoff team in 2021 regardless. The problem is though, fans believe that this team is automatically a title contender next season with the return of a healthy Curry and Klay, which is simply not the case. Unfortunately, the Warriors' current roster is not up to scratch if they wish to compete for a title yet again next season, and there will need to be some big changes this offseason if they wish to be legitimately viewed as contenders in 2021. That is the hard truth about the Golden State Warriors. And that will conclude the video. What do you guys think of this? How good would the Golden State Warriors be next season to you? Are they a title contender with their current roster, or do they need to make some changes? Let me know all your thoughts on this down in the comments below. If you enjoyed the video, be sure to drop it a like and subscribe, but with that being said, I am out. Peace.